Hey guys, how's it going? So I saw this 64 Chevrolet Impala SS pop up in marketplace. Decided to do a quick video on this thing just before it disappears. So this guy's got pretty well his basis covered for pictures, I think. We'll just go through them here. Just before I get into it though, I just like to start off. Boy, would this make a good YouTube car. It's got all the barnacles on it still. A good pressure wash video that would get a lot of views right there. Not gonna lie. Let's get into the pictures here. So, right off the bat, he's got the proper back end shot here. But I'll read you the ad first. 64 Chevrolet Impala. It's not $640. He wants $6,400 for this thing. He's got a pretty good description in here. He just kind of covers his ass. He must be putting up with a lot of stuff from people. First off, if you're reading this ad, it's still available. We will not reply to, is this still available? 1964 Impala SS two-door hardtop car was shipped from Georgia many years ago and left in a barn up here, apparently. It's a factory AC car, factory 327 Auto Trans, no driveline in it. Car is a restoration project, so he's got his grounds covered there. A super clean frame, he states, and rockers, all original metal. Comes with brand new silver interior from headliner to carpet. Call if serious. If you're reading this ad, it's still available. No trades. $6,400. Okay. So, he pretty well stated it's a project car. I mean, I think enough is said there. It's going to need a bit of metal work. A little bit of rust at the bottom. I mean, this is just typical stuff. Car is in 1964, so it is what it is, right? Overall, it's pretty complete-ish. I mean, realistically, all you'd have to get is probably bumpers. I guess a bumper for it, and you're probably going to have to do some patchwork, obviously. This would be like an intermediate project, but you could, I don't know. If you had a welder and stuff, and you could probably just patch whatever you needed to patch, and I would just probably pressure wash this car and try to clean it up as best as I could. I mean, it's a no-engine car, so I mean, again, I would definitely either drop a small block in it or possibly my 6-liter, like I always say. So there's a front-end view of this thing. Like I said, this guy's got all the basis pictures covered pretty well. It looks like it might be pretty solid, but I mean, until I get all the barnacles off, you don't really know. But I mean, it is what it is. Like I said, 1964, so there's going to be rust. Obviously, there's rust on this car, so. I mean, the engine bay doesn't look too bad, really. I mean, good pressure wash, and honestly, you could probably just wire a wheel out of that and just give it a coat of chassis black or some sort of black from Eastwood paint, I guess. That's probably what I would do. I mean, everything looks pretty solid in here. Just fix what needs to be fixed. There's the interior. Seats need to be redone, obviously, and there might be some patchwork in the floor that may need to be done. You can't really see down there, but it looks like there might be a hole or two. Good side shot. Got the whole car in there. Like I said, just a good pressure wash to this thing. I kind of really, I would just love to keep that the way that it is. Frig, I wish I had the money on me right now. It's close by too, so. 64 Chev, frig me. There's the other side. I mean, not bad. Lots of barnacles. It's got the original, hubcaps on it. Frig, this car will not last, I can tell you that right now. Somebody will snag up on this. Looks like a passenger side view shot here. Can't really complain about anything too much. He states it's a project car, so. But yeah, everything is, you know, pretty complete-ish, so. Might have to hunt down a few things. I imagine these dashes are pretty hard to find. It's all cracked up here. I don't know if you, what you can, if they make restoration ones for this car. I do not know. It's got the old sweep dash in it there. So that's it. What he has for pictures. I mean, I think he's got his grounds covered for pictures here. I'm not going to complain about that. I mean, he's got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. He's got 10 pictures, and he's got all his assets pretty well covered here. Yeah, just a nice patina car for sure. Might be a little bit of grinding in here you might need to do. Could be some Bondo maybe, but you can still see the Impala letters there. Overall, looks pretty solid, I must say. The only thing he doesn't have, though, is a trunk picture. That's one thing, too. Just about forgot about that. He could have lifted the trunk up and snagged a picture in there. But, like I said, he says it's a project, so he can only imagine, right? Yeah, this thing would be hot with a 6-liter in it. Holy shit. Imagine that, 4L80. Shift kit and all decked out, and LS and nice rowdy exhaust on it. I figured that'd be badass. And I'd probably even just keep these hubcaps on there, just for keep these wheels on with a 6.0 on it. Might as well make it look stock on the outside. I don't mind that look right there, actually, one bit. So it's got, I wonder if it's got all four hubcaps on it. Oh yeah, very good. Yeah, that car would be a wicked ass sleeper. Yeah, I'd probably have to source out some trim there. I don't know if he said he had that or not. I'm not too sure. Maybe there's some pieces in the trunk, who knows. But yeah, overall, not too shabby of a car, really. Pretty decent project to start out with. Let me know what you guys think. Thanks a lot for watching, and I'll catch you in the next one. Cheers.